Welcome back, paper crafters. I'm here to show you today how to make this adorable basket. And I saw a picture on some website, blog, Pinterest, you name it. And I thought, I wonder if I could recreate that. And so after a few shots, I came up with this really cute basket. So using that 8.5 by 11 wheeled paper that we designed in an earlier broadcast, I'm going to show you how to go from this to this. Starting out, what I call is the 8.5 by 11 edge, you're going to score at 3.25 and 5.25. And then flip your paper around and you're going to do the 11 inch side and you're going to score at 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you have to open up this handy measuring arm. 7, 8, 9. And 10. These measurements will be posted on my blog with this project. Then you're going to fold each one of those crevices, or each one of those score marks. Not to worry about that, it's going to get cut anyway. So, you know, most of you know me that an oops is just a way to make it better. This is all about your creativity. It's not about being perfect. You're supposed to relax and enjoy stamping. So using my bone folder, I'm going to score down the center. Remember, we're at that 3.25 and 5.25. And then I'm gonna fold at the 1-inch mark, 2-inch mark, 3-inch mark, and 4-inch mark. Flip the paper over, and again, you're going to fold along those score lines that we had made earlier. One at a time. And once that's all done, then you're going to cut at each fold here, 2, 3, and the 4-inch, you're gonna cut up to your center. And then also on the 7, 8, 9, and 10, cut in. Okay, so now I have each one of these sections all cut just like so, okay? That's what you're supposed to end up with. Now, for a little bit of adhesive, I'm gonna use our handy dandy snail, and I'm going to just add snail at the top edge of this larger center slit, one on both, little strip on both ends. And then I'm gonna flip this over and add a bit of snail on each one of the inside, or the back side, or the non-printed side, however you wanna look at it, of these small strips, the 1-inch wide strips, okay? Now, taking the larger strip, okay, and then the very two right next to it, you're going to bring those in and have them overlap a tad till they're about even, and then press them onto that centerpiece. Move to the next ones and do the same thing, okay? And the next ones, just like so. making sure that they are somewhat even. Remember, it doesn't have to be perfect. And then the top ones will adhere to that last bit of glue or adhesive that we put at the top of that topper flap. So just like that, you have your basket and side completed, and the inside here is the square piece that you have connected those all to. Okay, so going right back to the next side, you're going to do the same thing. Bring it up, overlap them a touch, and see that they are somewhat even again, and then continue working side to side, overlapping, adhering, until you have come to the very last one, and that one is somewhat straight across. Doesn't have to be straight across. You can leave it with a little bit of an indent if you want to, but I made mine straight across. And there you have, is such a cute and simple little weaved basket. Now I do want to show you on this prototype that I did. Here is the one side that you can see those woven basket-like pieces of paper. And this side is where I took the square center and put it on the outside and kind of left this fan look on the underside, which this is cute because you could put some background paper, you could add a greeting, just whatever you wanted to. So it gives you a little two looks. This also has a dip because you have to make sure that you get those connected to the back side, to whereas this side is straight across. So you have two options to this super cute basket. Now I did add a handle on this one, and basically all I did was run my wheel across the 11 inch length of a piece of cardstock, and then I cut this about an inch wide and I glued it from one side to the next. You could also glue it if you wanted to from these outside edges too. So super cute little craft basket that, being that this had the ticket punch, the ticket wheel on it, I thought it would be cute to add some popcorn and maybe some movie tickets to make a great dad's gift. So, or a guy's birthday present or anything like that. So thanks for stopping by. I hope you have enjoyed how to make this. Again, if you have any questions, you can email me or leave comments on the blog, and I will answer your comments as soon as I can. And if you ask questions, and everybody learns that way too. So thanks for stopping by. Hope you come back soon.